It is now the fourth day of Iceland's latest volcanic eruption, and as a result, we have a new problem, the potential for large explosions. However, I am strangely not referring to true volcanic explosions such as the ones frequently witnessed during the daily eruptions of Guatemala's Fuego volcano. Rather, I am referring to actual explosives, as the expansion of lava flows during the last 24 hours has made the northern lobe advance through a shooting and artillery range the U.S. Army used during parts of the 1950s and 1960s. As a result, there is a fear that the heat from the lava could detonate some explosives, as this heat peaks at around 1200 degrees Celsius or 2192 degrees Fahrenheit. I was unable to figure out an exact outline of where this ordnance might be or what exactly might have been dropped on it, but this could very well include 250-plus pound aerial bombs and M110-155mm artillery shells. Although I am not an explosives expert, so what I am about to say could be very wrong, it appears that the explosives used in these bombs could contain tritanol, menol, or TNT. The first two will most definitely explode upon contact with intense heat, while the third will probably not and simply just melt. The largest of these has a safe radius of around 1600 meters when they detonate, so this is another reason why people should get no closer than this to the slowly advancing lava flow. Only a single lava flow is expanding the lava field at the present, and yes, this is traveling to the north, but it, in my opinion, is occurring at such a slow rate that I do not think it will eventually reach the road 3,350 meters to the north. Instead, I expect the lava to largely spread out rather than solely go only northwards. What is strange about the current eruption is that it has not yet progressed into a true spatter cone-forming stage, like all five prior eruptions had at this point. Instead, there are still at least two 100-meter-long fissures erupting and calling the 25-meter-high ridges that have grown alongside these as spatter cones might be a bit of a stretch. The slow progression seems to point towards the distinct possibility that the ongoing eruption could last longer than the March to May 2024 eruption, which lasted 54 days. However, only time will tell if it will still be erupting on October 14th, or even when I physically visit this part of Iceland. Yes, I will be there on September 7th and 8th. I have had a few people ask me how long it would take for me to classify the Reykjanes volcano or the current eruption in particular as being a shield volcano. For context, I consider the Reykjanes volcano, which is spread across an area of 470 square kilometers across dozens of vents, to be best described as a fissure system. This shouldn't be all that surprising when you physically look at this part of the peninsula, since its eruptions generally occur along northeast trending fissures. The key difference here is that there is no singular dominant fissure. For me to truly describe the Reykjanes volcano as a shield volcano, it would need a singular dominant vent to construct a large central edifice in the shape of a shield, and this has clearly not happened, and is unlikely to happen anytime during the next 10,000 years. However, this doesn't mean that a small shield volcano couldn't form as a monogenetic vent. We only have to go 12.5 kilometers to the west-southwest to see one such small shield volcano which erupted 12,500 years ago. If the current eruption eventually does build a singular spatter cone, and this continues to erupt upwards of 8 months, a true monogenetic shield volcano might form. As a final note, here is a current map of where the Reykjanes volcano's eruption plume is affecting, and here is a photo showing the fog it caused at Cornwall in the United Kingdom.